Understanding cryptocurrency wallets, private and public keys are actually pretty critical to understanding how cryptocurrencies work. It sounds complicated and it may even put you off storing, spending, or sending your crypto, but don't let it. In this video, we'll cover the difference between a cryptocurrency wallet, a private and also a public key. If you've watched our previous Bitpanda Academy video, What is a Wallet?, you may remember the points made that a cryptocurrency wallet is actually not a physical item, like the leather wallet in your back pocket, but more of a safety deposit box or a vault. To access your assets and to withdraw them, you need a dedicated key, or in other words, a password. Every wallet address will have a private and a public key. The private key allows you to access the funds related to your wallet address, and think of this as the password to the wallet. We'll cover this in more depth in future Academy videos. A wallet address is a randomly generated set of numbers and letters. This usually consists of around 26 to 35 characters. A wallet address is ideally a one-time link generated by a wallet. Wallet addresses are actually needed to send and also receive digital assets. So now, in order to access your wallet address, you need to have your public and your private keys. So what are the difference between the two? Well, in cryptography, a public key and a private key are both needed to access any encrypted information. Cryptography is the practice of encrypting certain information to keep it secret from those third parties. Think of this as a different language that only parties with permission have access to. So now, what is cryptography? Well, cryptography, the term, actually came from Greek roots, originally meaning secret writing. Over the time, cryptography evolved from intelligence agencies and military, writing and decoding different confidential messages, and even becoming a separate branch of computer science. Similar to the internet, the origins of cryptocurrencies can actually be traced back to academic and military use cases, which eventually expanded into the private sphere. So people involved in this movement actually refer to themselves as cyberpunks, and they have been advocating this shift to greater privacy and greater control over our data since the late 1980s. Now let's move on to the two-key system and why it's used. The basic concept behind the two-key system is the following. The public key allows you to receive transactions, while the private key is necessary to send transactions. It gets a little bit more complicated when we take a look at how the system actually works. So using two different keys, a public and a private key, is called asymmetric cryptography, which is a vital aspect of the blockchain. The two keys are connected to each other in mathematical terms. The unique public key has its origins inside the private key. Well, this connection of the two actually allows users to create an unforgeable signature, which can only be validated by the other participants of the network who have knowledge of the corresponding public key. So we've covered an overview on the two-key systems and also cryptography, but back to the wallets, the private and also the public keys, what are the differences? Well, an address is a randomly generated set of numbers and letters which actually represent a type of unique numbers similar to a bank account. As an example, here is the Bitcoin Genesis address, the first Bitcoin address ever, on the screen here. So the difference is that an address can be generated for free by anyone within a matter of seconds without needing a third party. You can create as many public addresses as you like or as you need, and you can freely share your public addresses with others. That way people can actually send cryptocurrencies to your address. So because the Bitcoin or Ethereum networks are actually not anonymous at all but pseudonymous, your holdings and transactions actually can be viewed by anyone who knows your public address. So now let's move on to keys. There are two types of keys, public keys and also private keys. First, we'll take a look at public keys. Public keys are comparable to account numbers. They can be freely shared with everyone and anyone can potentially send transactions to them. Private keys, on the other hand, should be kept private, as the name suggests. You can think of them as kind of like a PIN code or verification code, which together with the corresponding public key grants you access to the actual funds on the blockchain. So note that the keys are actually not stored on a blockchain. Instead, they can be kept on an encrypted file, which can be saved anywhere and stored offline. Now, you should never, under any circumstance, share your private keys with any other person. It's really best to store them in the most secure way possible, be that a paper wallet or a hardware wallet. Now let's move on to wallets. You can actually think of a wallet as sort of like an encrypted virtual keychain containing all of the information needed to access your funds on the Bitcoin blockchain. A wallet combines and contains both of your addresses as well as your digital keys. The simplest form of a wallet is a file containing a database. It can also be stored offline because it doesn't need an internet connection to get on the blockchain. So like we've covered in previous Bitpanda YouTube videos on what is a wallet is a storage vault for your addresses, public keys, and also your private keys. Well, I hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions or you want to learn any more about the industry, be sure to subscribe to the Bitpanda channel and turn on the notifications so you don't miss any more content like this.